All right, so our speaker today is Hiroshi Sakai from Kobe University. And Hiroshi is going to speak on generalized stationary reflection and cardinal arithmetic. Hiroshi, it's great to have you here. We could never get you to come to New York, so we got you there enough. Go ahead.
Okay, so thank you very much for introduction, and thank you very much for inviting me to this nice seminar. So today I'm going to talk about generalized stationary reflection and cardinal arithmetic. So in my talk, stationary reflection means stationary reflection in P omega 1 lambda, which is often called a weak reflection principle, WRP. And today we discuss consequences of its generalization on cardinal arithmetic. Okay, so first we recall generalized stationary reflection principle. So first of all, we recall original stationary reflection principle, which is so-called WRP. So stationary reflection principle is this reflection. So let SR omega 1 be the following stationary reflection principle. For any set H, including omega 1, and any stationary subset X of P omega 1 H, there is R, subset R of H, such that the size of R is equal to omega 1, and omega 1 is included in R. So this is some technical property. So main property is this one. The size of R is omega 1, and stationarity of X reflects to R, which means that X intersection with P omega 1 R is stationary in P omega 1 R. So this is my favorite stationary reflection principle. So as I said, SR omega 1 is often called the weak reflection principle, WRP. And in former Magidashvili's well-known paper on Martin's maximum, it is proved that SR omega 1 holds if a supercompact cardinal is Levy collapsed to omega 2. And also, Martin's maximum implies SR omega 1. Okay, so SR omega 1 is known to have many interesting consequences. Here, SR omega 1 implies the following. So Chang's conjecture, NS omega 1 is presaturated, and all omega 1 stationary preserving posets are semi-proper. And also, it has a consequence on cardinal arithmetic. So SR omega 1 implies 2 to the omega is less than or equal to omega 2. And it implies that a singular cardinal hypothesis. So from these two, 4 and 5, so it follows that lambda to the omega is equal to lambda for any regular lambda greater than or equal to omega 2. So today we study consequences on cardinal arithmetic of higher analogs of SR omega 1. So before going to higher analogs, we recall the proof of this one. SR omega 1 implies 2 to the omega is less than or equal to omega 2. Okay. So, yeah, key point of the proof of this SR omega 1 implies 2 to the omega is less than or equal to omega 2 is this Baumgartner's theorem. So, which says that every club subset Z of P omega 1 omega 2 has size omega 2 to the omega. So, this is an important, so key theorem. So proof of this one is a little bit difficult. But using this Baumgartner's theorem, we can easily prove that SR omega 1 implies 2 to the omega is less than 1 equal to omega 2. So proof is like this. Okay. So assume SR omega 1. So for each gamma in omega 2, which is greater than omega 1, uncountable gamma, so we can take a club the gamma subset of P omega 1 gamma with the size omega 1. So this is because we can take such a club because gamma has size omega 1. And we can take an increasing continuous cofinal sequence in P omega 1 gamma, which becomes a club size omega 1. Okay. Okay. So let Z be the union of all the gammas. All, okay. Then clearly the size of Z is equal to omega 2. And P omega 1 omega 2 set minus Z. So complement of Z is non-reflecting, does not reflect to any gamma in omega 2 set minus omega 1. Then by SR omega 1, we have that P omega 1 omega 2 complement of Z set minus Z is non-stationary. So SR omega 1 says that every stationary set reflects. So here, complement of Z is non-reflecting. So complement of Z is non-stationary. That is, Z contains a club. Okay, so by Baumgartner's theorem, then the size of Z must be equal to omega 2 to the omega. But we have that the size of Z is equal to omega 2. So omega 2 to the omega is equal to omega 2. So we have 2 to the omega is less than 1 equal to omega 2. So this is a, proof of this one. Okay, so this is a key theorem for this proof. Okay, so next, so we discuss higher analog of SR omega 1, but it is well known that straightforward generalization is inconsistent. And first, we look at inconsistent generalization. So for a kappa greater than or equal to omega 1, let SR kappa be the following stationary diffraction principle. So basically, this is the one obtained by replacing omega 1, so parameter omega 1 to kappa from SR omega 1. So for any set H including kappa and any stationary subset X of P kappa H, there is a subset R of H such that the size of R is equal to kappa and kappa is included in R and X intersection P kappa R is stationary in P kappa R. So this is just a changing parameter omega 1 to kappa. So we call it SR kappa, okay? So it is known that this straightforward generalization is inconsistent for kappa greater than, bigger than omega 1. So so in ZFC, SR kappa fails for any regular cardinal kappa bigger than omega 1. So this is known. Okay. So on the other hand, the restriction of SR kappa to stationary sets consisting of internally approachable sets is consistent. So next, we recall the notion of internally approachable sets. Okay, so here is a notion of internally approachable set. Let M be a set and mu be a regular cardinal. So for a regular, for a limit ordinal zeta, M is said to be internally approachable of length zeta if there is an increasing sequence M xi, xi less than zeta, such that union of M xi is equal to M. And every proper initial segment of this sequence belongs to M. So we call such sequence MXs internally approaching sequence to M or something like this. Okay, so we say that M is internally approachable if M is IA of length zeta for some zeta. Also, we say that M is IA of cofinality mu if M is a A of length zeta for some zeta with cofinality mu. I think this is a natural definition and many of you know. So we consider these classes. So IA is a class of all M which is internally approachable. And IA mu is a class of all M, which is IA of cofinality mu. And IA less than mu is a class of all M, which is IA of cofinality less than mu. And IA bigger than mu is, class of all M, which is IA of cofinality bigger than mu. Okay, so we consider the restriction of stationary reflection to this class. So before going to restriction of stationary reflection, so we recall stationarity of internally approachable set. So let mu, kappa, and lambda be regular cardinals with mu is smaller than kappa and kappa is less than or equal to lambda. Then it is known that p kappa h lambda intersection with IA mu is stationary in p kappa h lambda. And if mu is equal to, if mu is equal to omega and kappa is equal to omega one, then it is club. So P omega one H lambda intersection with IA omega is club in P omega one H lambda. Also, it is known that a complement of IA is stationary. So if kappa is bigger than omega one, then complement of IA is stationary in P kappa H lambda. Okay. Okay, so we consider restriction of generalized stationary reflection to the class IA. So suppose C is a subclass of IA. So in my talk, C is IA or IA omega or IA bigger than omega. So IA omega is internally approachable of cofinality, countable cofinality. And IA bigger than omega is the class of all internally approachable sets of uncountable cofinality. So in my talk, C is IA or IA omega or IA bigger than omega. So for a regular cardinal kappa bigger than omega one, so let SR kappa restricted to C be the following. So the difference difference from the previous one is just this restriction, intersection C. So for any regular lambda bigger than kappa, and any stationary subset X of P kappa H lambda intersection with C. So this is the difference. There is a subset R of H lambda such that the size of R is equal to kappa and kappa is included in R. And the stationarity of X reflects to R, which means that X intersection with P kappa R is stationary in P kappa R. Okay, so this is a restriction of generalization of stationary reflection. So in my talk, we also consider slight strengthening of this SR kappa restricted to C, so which we call SR star kappa restricted to C. So for a regular cardinal kappa bigger than or equal to omega 1, let SR star kappa restricted to C be the following differences here. So for any regular lambda and any stationary subset X of P kappa H lambda intersection with C, there is R, subset R of H lambda such that here, so we require that R is internally approachable of length kappa. So this is the difference. And X intersection with P kappa R is stationary in P kappa R. So this is the same. Okay. So it is known that this restriction of stationary reflection is consistent, but so basic facts is this. So obviously, SR kappa restricted to IA is equivalent to SR kappa restricted to IA omega and SR kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega. So this is just because IA is a union of IA omega and IA bigger than omega. Also, SR omega 1 is equivalent to SR omega 1 restricted to IA. So this is just because IA is clubbed in P omega 1 H lambda. Okay. Hello. So.
Hi, this is Denise. I'm calling from Harwich for Evening Isolate.
Oh, yeah. Hi.
How are you?
Yeah, we're okay. Thanks.
Sorry. Could everybody turn off their mic,
sure,
please?
Hold on a second. Let me get that.
Okay.
I'm sorry about that.
No, it's okay.
Okay.
Please mute yourselves if you're not asking a question.
Actually, so my baby is crying next room. Is it okay?
Oh, I would love to hear the baby much more than phone call.
It's on the speaker's end. We don't have to bother the speaker.
So, yeah, Rita, so please don't mind. Okay, so by this second fact, this restriction of stationary reflection to IA can be seen as some kind of natural generalization of SR omega 1 to higher cardinal. So also, as I said, this restriction is known to be consistent. So for a regular uncountable cardinal kappa, if a supercompact cardinal bigger than kappa is Levy collapsed to kappa plus, then this stronger reflection, SR star kappa restricted to IA holds. So this stationary reflection restriction is consistent. Okay. So we study consequences of these generalized stationary diffraction principles on cardinal arithmetic. Okay, so we go to the main part of my talk, generalized stationary diffraction and the cardinal arithmetic. So, so far, any questions? Is it okay? Okay, so let's go to the main part of my talk. So first of all, we have this theorem one. So it's about power of omega. So recall that SR omega one implies that lambda to the omega is equal to lambda for all regular cardinal, lambda bigger than omega two. So by the same argument, we can prove the following. So let kappa be a regular uncountable cardinal, then SR kappa restricted to IA omega implies that lambda to the omega is equal to lambda for all regular cardinal lambda bigger than kappa plus. So it implies that 2 to the omega is less than or equal to kappa plus, and SCH holds above kappa. So this is not so important, but so as for 2 to the omega less than or equal to kappa plus, so this one to prove this one, so we use the following modification of Baumgartner's theorem. So for any club Z, club subset Z of P kappa H kappa plus, we have that the set of all M intersection kappa plus, where M is in Z intersection with IA omega. So this set has size kappa plus to the omega. So proof of this one is almost the same as Baumgartner's theorem, and using this theorem, using this generalization, we can easily prove that SR kappa restricted to IA omega implies 2 to the omega less than or equal to kappa plus. Yeah, almost the same argument. Okay. So this is a restate of theorem one. So SR kappa restricted to IA omega implies that lambda to the omega is equal to lambda for all regular lambda bigger than kappa plus. So 2 to the omega is less than or equal to kappa plus, and SCH above holds above kappa. So from this theorem, so several questions naturally arise. So first, so here SR kappa restricted to IA omega implies lambda to the omega. So this is somewhat unsatisfiable. So because this parameter kappa is bigger than omega one, so we want to expect that lambda, for example, lambda to the omega one does. Okay, so does SR kappa restricted to IA give any bound on 2 to the mu for an uncountable mu? The second question is, second and third question is like this. So here, for this consequence, a restriction to IA omega is enough. So the second and the third question says that does the restriction to IA bigger than omega, so does it give, does it say anything about cardinal arithmetic? So does SR kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega give any bound on 2 to the omega? And does SR kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega imply SGH? I guess these three questions are natural questions. And I think if you are familiar with this topic, you will conjecture answer of all these questions are no. And actually, I could prove it. So yeah, we give negative answers to all these questions. So SR kappa restricted to IA does not give any bound on 2 to the mu for any uncountable mu. And SR kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega does not say anything about cardinal arithmetic. Okay. Okay, so among these three questions, easiest question is this second one. Does SR kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega give any bound on 2 to the omega? So this is an easiest question. So we start from this second question. So question, does SR kappa restricted to IA of uncountable cofinality give any bound on 2 to the omega? So as I said, answer is no. In fact, SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega does not give any bound. So forcing is very simple. So add omega or something like this. So for a regular cardinal mu and an ordinal nu, so add mu nu is less than mu closed poset, adding nu many subsets of mu. So this is just very simple standard forcing, mu closed forcing, adding nu many subsets of mu. So i.e. That is less than mu support product of nu many copies of less than mu 2. Okay, so this is the easiest forcing which blows up 2 to the mu. So theorem 2 says that, so basically this says that SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega is preserved by add omega nu. So this says that even if you add co-NDRs arbitrarily, many co-NDRs, SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega is preserved. So assume GCH and suppose kappa is a regular cardinal bigger than omega 1 and SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega holds in the ground model. So let nu be an arbitrary ordinal. Then SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega remains to hold in add omega nu extension. So here we observe outline of the proof of theorem, this theorem. Is it okay? So this is a preservation theorem of SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega.
And you can always arrange GCH without destroying the reflection principle? So
this is technical assumption. And I think we don't need this assumption. But in my proof, I use this one. Okay. Is it okay?
I guess my question was, if you're in a model where this reflection principle holds and GCH fails, can you force to a model where GCH holds and while preserving the principle? Or is it really an extra assumption to, reflection principle holds, can you show that you don't spoil anything by adding GCH?
I don't know.
Okay.
Okay, so yeah, so we give an outline of the proof of this theorem too. So my proof of theorem two is based on the, I guess this may be well known, preservation of ordinal stationary diffraction principle. So our proof of theorem two is based on the proof of the preservation of the ordinal stationary diffraction principle, where ordinal stationary diffraction principle is stationary diffraction principle in stationary sets of ordinals. So for a regular cardinal lambda bigger than omega two and a stationary subset U of lambda, let OSR lambda restricted to U be the following assertion. So for example, lambda is equal to omega two and U is a set of all ordinals of cofinality omega. So this is often discussed. So for any stationary subset S of U, there is gamma smaller than lambda of uncountable cofinality such that S intersection gamma is stationary in gamma. So this is just a stationary diffraction principle restricted to subsets of U. So this is basic stationary diffraction principle. So Sera proves that OSR lambda restricted to U is preserved by any CCC forcing. So suppose OSR lambda restricted to U holds for a regular lambda bigger than omega two and a stationary subset U of lambda, then OSR lambda restricted to U remains to hold in any CCC forcing extension. So our proof of theorem two is based on this, the proof of this theorem. And yeah, proof of this theorem is easy. So let me give a proof of this theorem. So this is a restatement of the preservation of OSR lambda restricted to U. And here is a proof. So suppose OSR lambda restricted to U holds in the ground model, and let P be a CCC poset. And we work in the ground model. So let S dot be a P name such that S dot is a subset of U and S dot is non-reflecting. Okay. Let S dot be a P name such that S dot is a subset of U and S dot is non-reflecting. So we want to show that S dot, so P forces that S dot is non-stationary. So this says that every non-reflecting subset of U is non-stationary. So which means that every stationary subset of U reflects, and this says stationary diffraction. Okay. So since P forces S dot is non-reflecting, for each gamma in lambda of uncountable cofinality, so we can take a P name C dot gamma of a club subset of gamma such that P forces S dot does not intersection with C dot gamma. So this is just because S dot is non-reflecting. Is it okay? So this is next one is the point. Since P has a countable chain condition, and C dot gamma is a name of a club set, we can take a club D gamma subset of gamma in the ground model such that P forces D gamma is included in C dot gamma. So here is a point. This is a point. Okay. So let T be the U set minus union of all D gammas. Then since D gammas are club in gamma, this T is non-reflecting in so now we are discussing in the ground model. Okay, so T is non-reflecting. So, but in the ground model, stationary reflection holds. So T is non-stationary. Okay. But we have that P, okay, so we have that S dot is a subset of T just because P forces S dot intersection with C dot gamma is empty and D gamma is a subset of C dot gamma. So we have that T dot is a subset of T, P forces. So since T is non-stationary in the ground model, it is non-stationary in the extension. So we have that P forces S dot is non-stationary. So this is a proof. I guess this is a simple, but yeah, nice proof. Okay. So we want to generalize this proof to preservation of stationary reflection in P kappa H, so SR kappa. So main difficulty is as follows. So as I said, so main part of this proof is here. So since P has CCC, we can take a club D gamma, blah, blah, blah. So this part can be, generalized to P kappa H context, so in a straightforward way. So this part is okay in the generalization. So what is the difference between preservation of ordinary stationary reflection and the stationary reflection principle in P kappa H? So differences are like this. So in ordinary stationary reflection principle, the base set lambda or base set U here is the same, does not change after forcing. But in the P kappa H context, in the stationary reflection in P kappa H, so the base set P kappa H may change after forcing. So this is a problem. So for example, so in the OSR case, U base set U does not change. And this is implicitly used here. So here we discuss in the ground model and we can take U, but in the P kappa H context, this base set becomes a name, U dot or something like this. And we cannot discuss this in the ground mode, so I cannot explain well, but okay, so in the next slide, I will explain a little bit more. Okay, so preservation for a problem for preservation of SR. So a difficulty in proving the preservation of SR kappa restricted to C. So this is a stationary diffraction in P kappa H comes from the fact that the P kappa H changes after forcing. So even for the same H. So this is a problem. So for example, so let me explain why stationary diffraction in P omega 1 omega 2 is not preserved by Cohen forcing, adding Cohen real. So for example, let kappa be omega 1 and H be omega 2. Suppose nu is bigger than omega 2 to the omega in the ground model, and G is add omega nu generic filter over the ground model. Then in the extension, so we look at P omega 1 omega 2 of the ground model. So this has in the ground model, so P omega 1 omega 2 of the ground model has size omega 2 to the omega of the ground model. But here we add nu is bigger than, so blow up the 2 to the omega bigger than omega 2 to the omega. This is strictly smaller than omega 2 to the omega of the extension. Then by Baumgartner's theorem in the extension, so P omega 1 omega 2 of the ground model does not contain a Krapf subset. Is it okay? So Baumgartner's theorem says that every Krapf subset of P omega 1 omega 2 has size omega 2 to the omega. Okay. So that is in the extension, complement of P omega 1 omega 2 of the ground model is stationary. So yeah. Original P omega 1 omega 2 is co-stationary in the extension. And actually in the above situation, we have no control of this complement. And in fact, it is easily shown to be non-reflecting. So this is the reason why, so add omega nu does not preserve stationary diffraction in P omega 1 omega 2. Is it okay? So the main difficulty is this one. So even for the same H, P kappa H changes after forcing. Okay. So the following key lemma allows us to avoid this difficulty. So in the previous slide, so here is a key lemma. So let kappa be a regular cardinal bigger than omega 1 and nu be an ordinal. Then suppose G is an add omega nu generic filter over B. Then in the extension, for any sufficiently large regular cardinal lambda, there is a Krapf subset Z of P kappa H lambda. So here, this H lambda is the one in VG, such that M intersection with B, M intersection with H lambda B belongs to B. For any M in Z intersection with IA bigger than omega. So this key lemma is a little bit complicated, but basically it says that in the extension, for almost all M in IA bigger than omega, M intersection V, so trace of M, M intersection with B belongs to B. So, So it almost says that P kappa H lambda intersection with IA bigger than omega does not change by add omega nu or something like this. So this key lemma, with this lemma, a slight modification of the proof of the preservation of ordinary stationary reflection proves theorem two. So theorem two says that SR kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega is preserved by this forcing. And as I said, stationary reflection restricted to IA omega give a bound on 2 to the omega, and difference is this lemma. So this lemma fails if we replace IA bigger than omega with IA omega. Okay. And the proof of this key lemma is not so hard using covering and approximation properties of add omega nu. And I guess, people in New York are familiar with covering and approximation properties. So let me explain proof of this key lemma. Okay, so first let us recall covering and approximation properties. So this is introduced by Hamkins, and let P be a poset and let kappa be a regular uncountable cardinal. So we say that P has a less than kappa covering property if the following holds in the extension P generic generic extension by P. So for any subset X of the ground model of size less than kappa, so X can be covered by a set Y in the ground model of size less than kappa. So this is a less than kappa covering property. And we say that P has a less than kappa approximation property if for any P generic filter G, we have the following in in VG. So for any subset X of the ground model, basically this says that if all small parts of X belongs to the ground model, then X itself is in V. Okay, so if X intersection with Y is in the ground model, for all Y in V with of size less than kappa, then X itself belongs to V. So well-known lemma by Mitchell says that suppose nu is an ordinal, then add omega nu has a less than kappa covering and less than kappa, actually less than omega one covering and less than omega one approximation properties for regular uncountable cardinal kappa. Okay. So using this, we can prove the easily the key lemma. So let us recall key lemma. So let kappa be a regular cardinal bigger than omega 1 and nu be an ordinal. So suppose G is an add omega nu generic filter over B. Then in VG, for any sufficiently large regular cardinal lambda, there is a club subset Z of P kappa H lambda. So here H lambda is the one in VG, such that M intersection B, so this is the same as M intersection B, belongs to B for any M in Z intersection with IA of uncountable cofinality. Okay, so proof is like this. Okay. So we work in the extension. So the definition of the club Z is very simple. Let Z be the set of all M in P kappa H lambda. So again, this H lambda is the one in the VG. All M in P kappa H lambda such that M is an elementary submodel of H lambda epsilon and H lambda B. So this H lambda B is a predicate. And M intersection kappa belongs to kappa. Then, yeah, it is very easy to see that this Z is club. So we want to show that this Z witnesses this key lemma. So we want to show that suppose M is in Z intersection with IA bigger than omega. So we want to show that M intersection H lambda B, so M intersection B belongs to B. Okay. So since this is a subset of the ground model B, so by the less than omega one approximation property of add omega nu, so it suffices to show that M intersection Y belongs to B for any countable Y in B. Is it okay? Okay. So suppose Y in the ground model and Y is countable. Okay. So we want to show that M intersection Y belongs to B. So since M is in IA bigger than omega, let's take an internally approaching sequence to M. So let M xi less than zeta, where zeta is of uncountable cofinality, be an internally approaching sequence of M. Then, since Y is countable and zeta is of uncountable cofinality, so we can take xi less than zeta such that M intersection Y is included in M xi intersection with Y. Okay, so by the less than kappa covering property and the fact that this M xi belongs to M, and M is an elementary submodel of this structure, we can take N in M intersection H lambda B, M intersection B, such that MXC intersection with H lambda B is included in N. And N has size less than kappa. So less than kappa covering property says that every set of size less than kappa is covered by covered by a set in the ground model of size less than kappa. And here, since M is an elementary submodel, so we have this N. So since the size of N is smaller than kappa, and N belongs to M, and M is an elementary submodel, and M intersection kappa belongs to kappa. So from this, it follows that N is a subset of M. Then M intersection Y is included in MXC intersection Y by the choice of MXC. And MXC intersection Y is included in N intersection Y with Y. This is just because MXC intersection with B is included in N. And N intersection Y is included in M intersection Y. So this is just because N is included in M. So all these are the same. So M intersection Y is equal to N intersection Y, but both N and Y belong to the ground model B. So N intersection Y belongs to the ground model. So I guess this is a standard use of covering and approximation property, and using this, we can prove that in the add omega new generic extension for almost all M in IA bigger than omega, we have that M intersection B belongs to B. Anyway, so using this key lemma, we can prove that theorem too, which says that SR kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega is preserved by add omega nu. Is it okay? Okay, so this concludes question.
Can I just ask a question really quickly then, before you move on from this section?
Sorry?
Can I just ask a question before you move on from this section?
Yes.
So, of course, you know, if you add more than kappa plus many Cohen reals, you have to kill SR kappa restricted to IA by the first argument you gave. But do you know what happens if you add less than kappa plus many Cohen reals? I mean, what happens if you add one Cohen real? Do you kill SR kappa restricted to IA omega or something like this? Do you know?
Yeah. So it fails after. So you mean that this theorem one?
I mean, just so you take the principle SR kappa restricted to IA omega, right?
Yeah.
So by theorem one, if you add, you know, kappa double plus many Cohen reals, you kill it. That's obvious. Yes. But yeah, what happens if you just add one Cohen real?
Oh, I can prove that one Cohen real is enough to violate this SR kappa IA omega. One Cohen real is enough. So, okay. So this is a problem for preservation of SR slides. And here I explained that complement of the P omega 1 omega 2 of the ground model is stationary after so large number of Cohen reals are added. But Gittick proves that this becomes stationary after adding a single Cohen real. So by the same argument, we can prove that adding a single Cohen real violate. So stationary diffraction restricted to IA omega. And yeah, it is well known that adding a single Cohen real violates SR omega 1. So by the same argument, we can prove it.
Oh, I see. Right. Yes. Okay. Great. Thank you.
Is it okay?
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So we proceed to next question. So next question is: so does SR kappa restricted to IA? So give any bound on 2 to the mu for an uncountable mu. So as I said, so SR kappa restricted to IA, actually IA omega, it implies 2 to the omega is less than or equal to kappa plus. And next question is, so SR kappa restricted to IA, give any bound on 2 to the mu for an uncountable mu. So as I said, answer is no. So in fact, SR star kappa restricted to IA does not give any bound. So it is not hard to see that SR star kappa restricted to IA does not give any bound on 2 to the mu for a regular mu bigger than kappa. So main part of the answer is so case for mu is smaller than kappa. Okay, so for a regular mu less than kappa, so we have the following. So basically, this theorem 3 says that, if mu is a regular uncountable cardinal, then SR star kappa restricted to IA is preserved by add mu nu. So this is a forcing adding new many generic subsets of mu. Okay, so state is this. So assume GCH in the ground model. So suppose kappa is a regular cardinal bigger than omega 1 and kappa is in I kappa. So this I kappa is Schirra's approachability ideal, and I don't explain this in detail. So this is a some weak assumption, and SR kappa star restricted to IA holes. So let mu be a regular uncountable, here uncountable is important, less than kappa, and mu be an ordinal. Then SR star kappa restricted to IA remains to hold in add mu new generic extension. Okay, so this SR star kappa restricted to IA does not give any bound on 2 to the mu. Okay, so in this, to prove this theorem 3, we have a similar key lemma as in the previous case. So as in theorem 2, using the following lemma, a slight modification of the proof of the preservation of OSR proves theorem 3. So this is a similar lemma. So assume GCH holds and let kappa be a regular cardinal bigger than omega 1 such that kappa belongs to I kappa, and let mu be a regular uncountable cardinal smaller than kappa, and nu be an ordinal, and let G be a add mu new generic filter over B. So this is the so same assumption as theorem 3. Then in the extension, for any sufficiently large regular cardinal lambda, there is a curve Z, curve subset Z of P kappa H lambda such that M intersection with B belongs to B for any M in Z intersection IA, for any M in Z which is internally approachable. So actually, this is the main lemma. So I guess in my talk, the proof of this lemma is most difficult. So I just say, yeah, some not an idea, just to say some idea of the proof of this key lemma. So we decompose IA into IA smaller than mu, IA of coherentity less than mu, and IA of coherentity mu, and IA of coherentity bigger than mu. And so, yeah, we discuss, separately. So it suffices to prove the lemmas obtained by replacing this IA with IA smaller than mu and IA mu and IA bigger than mu. So this is just because IA is a union of all these three sets. So proof for IA bigger than mu is, almost the same as theorem to previous theorem. So actually previous key lemma use covering and approximation property. So proof for IA smaller than mu. So this can, this is the easiest one. Use the less than kappa covering property of less than mu closure of at mu nu. Using this, we can easily prove the lemma for IA smaller than mu. So the most difficult case is proof for IA mu. So basically, if coherentity is different from this mu, the proof is easy. But if the coherentity is the same, it's sometimes difficult. So proof for IA mu is by induction on lambda, and so we need some elaboration for lambda, which is a successor of a singular cardinal of coherentity mu, but I cannot explain an idea, but anyway, I could prove this key lemma, and using this key lemma, we could prove that preservation of SR kappa restricted to IA. Okay. So the last question is, SR kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega, does it imply singular cardinal hypothesis above kappa? So again, answer is no. In fact, SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega does not imply SCH. So here we have this preservation theorem of SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega. So basically this says that SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega. So this stationary reflection is preserved by pre-Curie forcing at above kappa. So suppose kappa is a regular cardinal bigger than omega one. And so this, small assumption. And here we want to assume GCH. So 2 to the mu is smaller than kappa for all cardinals mu. Below kappa. So here, so GCH below kappa or something like this. And SR star kappa is restricted to IA bigger than omega holes in the ground model. And let nu be a measurable cardinal bigger than kappa and p be a prickly forcing at nu. Then this prickly forcing preserves SR star kappa bigger restricted to IA bigger than omega. So of course, if 2 to the nu is bigger than nu plus in the ground model, then in the extension, SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega remains to hold, but SCH fails in the extension. So SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega does not imply SCH. So please note that the prickly forcing drastically changes p kappa lambda. So since prickly forcing changes cofinality, so p kappa lambda of the ground model is no more unbounded in the extension. So p kappa lambda is quite different between ground model and extension. And in this case, we cannot have the same key lemma as before, but we can prove some weak version. So I don't explain in detail. Yeah, but basically this says that, SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega is preserved by prickly forcing. Okay, so summary and question is like this. So let kappa be a regular cardinal bigger than omega 1. Then SR kappa restricted to IA omega, so IA of cofinality, IA of countable cofinality implies lambda to the omega is equal to lambda for regular lambda bigger than kappa. So 2 to the omega is less than or equal to kappa plus, and SCH holds. So SR kappa restricted to IA say something about power of omega, but it does not give any bound on 2 to the mu for any regular uncountable mu. And these two says that SR star kappa restricted to IA of uncountable cofinality does not say anything about cardinal arithmetic. SR star kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega does not give any bound on 2 to the omega and does not imply SCH. Okay, so I do not know the answer of the following question. So does SR kappa restricted to IA bigger than omega, or SR star kappa IA restricted to IA bigger than omega imply SCH at singular cardinal of uncountable cofinality? So in the proof of this one, so here IA of uncountable cofinality and prickly forcing makes measurable cardinal of countable cofinality. So this difference is essentially used. And I don't know. So in this question, so this is of uncountable cofinality and singular cardinal of uncountable cofinality. And so for this question, we have no more so difference of cofinality. So I don't know the answer of this question. So another question is, so generalized Rado's conjecture. So actually, so for this question, I don't know anything about this. So Rado's conjecture, RC omega 1, is the following assertion. So every non-special tree has a non-special subtree of size omega 1. And Todorovich proves that RC omega 1 implies that lambda to the omega is equal to lambda for all regular cardinal lambda bigger than y equal to omega 2. So, yeah, so the same as SR omega 1. And Lado's conjecture can be in the generalized in the straightforward way. And for Lado's conjecture, this is consistent. For a successor cardinal kappa, which is equal to mu plus, let RC kappa be the following assertion. So every non-mu special tree has a non-mu special subtree of size kappa. So here, mu special means that can be decomposed into mu many anti-chains. So this is a natural generalization of Rado's conjecture. And for this, it is known this RC kappa is consistent. And yeah, so actually now I'm working on this question. So does this generalization of Rado's conjecture have any consequences on cardinal arithmetic? And so, yeah, so I want to prove some preservation theorem of RC kappa, but for this, we need to deal with trees in the extension. And I don't know how to do it. Okay, but anyway, so that's all I wanted to say. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much, Hiroshi. That was a great talk. I really enjoyed it. Thank you. Are there any questions?
Yeah, I have a sort of a general question.
Yes.
You mentioned one of your last results that those special proof had to be given for the case of the successor to a singular cardinal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now that issue comes up, I remember, in a lot of Ronald Jensen's work on combinatorial principles for L, like diamonds and boxes, where the difficult case was always the successor to the singular cardinal. Otherwise, things would often went smoothly. So the way you handle that situation, is it any way like the way Jensen used to handle these successor to singular cardinal problems?
Sorry, you mean this question or?
Well, I'm just saying in a broad sense. I mean, I noticed that there has been in set theory a special sensitivity about successors to singular cardinals.
Yeah.
You know, and so how difficult is it here for you to get around to deal with this issue?
Okay, so for successor of singular cardinal, for this theorem, so this is a preservation of prickly forcing. This is not so relevant to successor, it's relevant, but this is not so difficult about successor of singular cardinal, but for this key lemma, so in the last case, mm-hmm. so by induction lambda, and the most difficult case is lambda is a success of singular cardinal of cofinality mu, and here we use scales and actually Schirra's PCF theory, so not a diamond and square, but yeah, some PCF. So it is well known that internally approachable sets are very so useful using scales and PCF theory. So here we use that idea.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anyone else?
I have a question. Do you know of any, I mean, so you showed us a lot of times that SR kappa restricted to I greater than omega doesn't imply something. Do you know of any positive consequences?
Sorry?
SR kappa restricted to I greater than omega. Right.
Yeah, SR restricted to I greater than omega, yes.
Yeah. What does it imply?
Oh, I see.
Some stationary reflection.
So not a cardinal arithmetic, but something else, you mean?
Yeah, just in general, I mean.
Yeah, in general. So do you know FRP for that type reflection principle? This implies higher analog of Fodor type reflection principle.
Oh, that's very interesting. Okay.
Yeah. So actually, we can prove that. So using this, we can prove that the higher analog of Fodor type reflection principle does not imply SGH.
I see. Okay. That's very interesting. Thank you.
Yeah.
Anyone else?
I guess I have a quick question. So going in the same direction as what Corey just asked, do you have any idea of how to strengthen these reflection principles in a natural way so that they do have some consequences on cardinal arithmetic?
Yeah. So that's I really want to do.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know.
I mean, adding the star as you did seems to go in the right direction, but it doesn't help as you're showing. Yeah.
Yeah. So, for example, so do you know, strong reflection principle by
right? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But it's very hard to prove that the consistency of high analog of Yeah, but that I want to do. And this is the first step of that project, I mean.
Right.
Yeah.
Do you know that SR kappa and SR star kappa are not equivalent?
Yeah, so for kappa is equal to omega one, I guess it's not equivalent. It may be open. So, John Kruger proved that SR omega one star, SR omega one star at P omega 1 omega 2 is not equivalent to SR. So Kruger proved that the star version of stationary reflection in P omega 1 omega 2 is strictly stronger than usual stationary reflection on P omega 1 omega 2. But I'm not sure, but I guess for the global version, it's still an open problem.
Anyone else? Anyone else? All right, so thanks, Hiroshi, very much. Once again, I really enjoyed your talk.
Yeah. And so at the end of my talk, so can I advertise a workshop of next week?
Okay,
so next week we will have a Kobe set theory workshop on the occasion of Sakae Fuchino's retirement. And so detail is like this. So yeah, workshop will take place next week, Zoom online workshop. And here is a web page and here is invited speakers. So Sakae Fuchino, Bagaria Hamkins, and many people. And so if you are interested in, please contact me or York by email or just visit this website. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, great.
It's very easy to register by just following the link and then you get the Zoom link once you're
registered. Yes.
I did that.
Thank you very much for your attention.